Amen.
Yes, amen.
But in that inquiry, God will send you the word of God.
Amen. Yes, he will.
Amen. We've got to stay in that place to hear it.
Amen.
David did. Yes. So David committed adultery. He laid with the Sheba. And let me tell you, church, one sin starts another sin.
Amen.
Into another sin.
Amen.
Amen. Until you own up to it.
Amen.
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 I want you to know that today. Until you own up to it. And you ain't got to own up to it to man. I'm talking about you own up to it to God.
Amen.
Amen. When you own up to it to God, that's when the sin stops.
Amen.
Amen. Because you turn from inquiring of your wants to inquiring of God, what do I do now?
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
Praise God.
Yes.
Amen. Because I tell you, the Bible teaches us, amen, praise God, that sin is pleasurable. Amen. Praise God. There's a place that you can get to want sin and not want God. Amen. Moses was put in that position. Amen. Moses was put into a place. Amen. And he had to make a decision. Amen. What he had and what he wanted more of. Amen. Even in the book of Hebrews chapter 11 verse 25, talking about Moses choosing rather to suffer the affliction with the people of God than to enjoy sin. And to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Amen. We have the choice to make, church. Amen. We can make that choice. Amen. Whether we want to sin or not. Amen. The choice is ours. Amen. But before we make that choice, God will send a warning unto us.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
He sent a warning unto him. But you know what I read and I found out? Adultery on David's part led to David trying to become a deceiver.
Come on.
You read the story. Goes on, and when David found out that Bathsheba was with child, he sent word to Joab to send me Uriah.
Come on.
You send me Uriah down here. Amen. David had a plot. David had a scheme. I'm going to hide her pregnancy. Amen. I'm going to get her husband to go in under her. Amen. But I'm going to tell you, he's trying to deceive the children of Israel. Amen. He's trying to deceive God. Let me tell you, you can't deceive God. You just got to own up to him. Amen. Praise God. And I'm going to tell you what. Amen. When we just own up to God, amen, we're much that more better off. Amen. Because we can't deceive God. Amen. David tried. Amen. So adultery led to deceit. Amen. And then when he tried to deceive him, amen, he tried to get him to go down. He'll tell me about the battle. Okay, I went down. You done told me all about the battle. I want you to go down into your house. Amen. Here's a big supper. Amen. I brought plenty of food. Amen. I want you to go down there and relax. Amen. Amen. And go down there and get with your wife. Didn't tell him that. That's what he intended for him to do.
Amen.
But see, David did not know the heart of Uriah.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
See, that deceiver,
yes,
does not know your heart.
Amen.
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 David didn't know the heart of Uriah.
Yes.
That's why I know David's mind was on not the things of God. David found out Uriah did not go down to his house. He slept by the Lord's house. He slept by the servants of David.
Yes.
Amen. David found out and asked him, why did you not go down to your house? Amen. He said, Lord, He said, King, he said, how can I go into my house when your servants, amen, Joab and the ark of God are abiding in tents? Amen. Yes. My servant, amen, my Lord Joab's lying in a tent in the field. The ark of God's in a tent. How can I go down to my house? Amen. David got himself in a position. Amen. He forgot the love of God. Amen. David got to a place. Amen. He forgot the loyalty to God. Amen. Praise God. And not only did he not see the loyalty of Uriah to himself and the ark of the living God. Amen. It was in David's mind. I've got to cover up my sin. I've got to cover up my sin. Amen. I'm going to tell you, church, if we ain't careful, we'll find ourselves in a position. I've got to cover up my sin. Amen. What can I do? Amen. I'll tell you what. I'm going to get him drunk. I'm going to have him go down. I know if he gets drunk, he's going to lay with his wife. Amen. I'll tell you what he did not do. Amen. Even though he got him drunk, he still would not go to his house.
Amen.
Because he did not know the heart of Uriah.
Amen.
Let me tell you, when you're sold out with God, you will be loyal.
Amen.
You will be faithful.
Amen.
Amen. That's a characteristic of Christ.
Amen. That's
Amen.
True.
That's a characteristic of God. God is loyal to you.
Yes,
God is faithful to you.
Amen.
Amen. He's not going to dump you. Amen. For another woman.
Amen.
Brother John Ray, he's not going to leave me and go to you. Amen. He's not going to leave you and go to me. Amen. He said, I'm going to love both of you. Amen. Praise God. I'm telling you, church. Amen. David got himself in a position. Amen. Where the lust of the flesh had overtaken his love for God.
Yes.
Amen.
That's what sin does.
Amen.
He said, well, since I couldn't get you drunk, son, you go lay with your wife, I'm going to have the courier killed. I'm going to have your word. I'm going to cover it up.
Oh, God.
At whatever cost.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm going to cover it up no matter what the cost is.
Yes.
See, there was no cost to David at that time.
Amen.
Who was higher than David? And it came in. I'm going to cover it up. So now adultery, no bed to deceit.
Come on, brother.
Deceit's leading to murder.
Oh, God. Come on.
Three things Jesus. God said you can't do.
Jesus.
So instead of just commit adultery, disobey one commandment, disobey three. He had Uriah killed. Then Nathan came. God sent word to David.
Amen.
Sent word to him. Said David, there was a rich man that had many sheep, many land. He said there was one poor man. He had one little lamb, raised it in his bosom, raised it as his own daughter. But the rich man took it and slew it and gave it to the rest of the world. Bible says wrath came up in David. David was very wroth. Who is this man? I'll take his life for doing such a dastardly deed. Brought a recompense against God. Who is this man, David? David said, it's your name.
Oh, God.
See, the only one that can get David's attention was God. Bible said David repented. Because Nathan said, God's going to kill you, David. after David passed judgment on his own self, who is this man? I will take his life. But God spared David because David repented. God accepted his repentance.
Amen.
He said, surely you will not die, David. But the soul will never leave your house. Let me tell you about sin. When we do those things, that soul will never leave our house.
Amen.
In other words, that opportunity for sin will never leave us.
Amen.
We will fight that sword every day.
Amen.
We will fight that desire every day. Let me tell you, church. James 1:13-15 says, let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God, for God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempted the evil man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Then when lust hath conceived it, bringeth forth sin, and sin when it is finished, bringeth forth death. Let me tell you, the Lord laid on my heart this morning. Amen. Sin just does not affect you. It affects your family and those around you. Amen. You know how I know? Amen. Because you look at David. You see how his family was affected. Amen. We know the little baby died. Amen. But I tell you what. Amen. It affected him. He had a son. Amen. That went and laid with his daughter. Amen. He had another son, Absalom. Killed Amon. Amen. Because Amon laid with Tamar. Amen. Praise God. You see how the circle of sin. Amen. Stayed in his home. Amen. Even though David loved God, and God loved David, amen, and God established David's throne, amen, because David would not heed the voice of the living God, amen, God never let it leave his home, amen.
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 True.
Tell you what the Lord showed me this morning. It says, when sin is finished, it brings forth death. Right? How does death affect a home? How does death affect a family? It affects everybody, doesn't it?
Yes.
Grandmama dies. Grandpa dies. It affects the sons, the daughters, the grandchildren, the great-grandchildren.
Yes.
It affects the friends, the cousins, and the families that come below them. That's what sin does.
Amen.
It just doesn't affect you. It affects me.
Yes.
It affects my wife, my children. That's what sin does. That's why God hates sin.
Amen.
Because it destroys family.
Amen.
And God's all about family.
Amen. Yes, God. Amen.
It destroys families.
Yes, it does.
And God's all about family.
Amen.
Amen. Because Jesus died so the family of God could find the Father. Amen. Romans 9:13. It says, as it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. Hebrews 12:16-17 says, lest there be any fornicator or profane person, as Esau, who for a morsel of meat sold his birthright. For ye know how that afterward, when he would have inherited the blessing, he was rejected, for he found no place of repentance, though he sought it carefully with tears. Amen. Let me tell you, church. Amen. You can reach a place, amen, that God will not hear your voice of repentance.
Amen.
Amen. I know we live in a church society, amen, that God's gracious, God's merciful. Amen. I've had them come tell me, amen, if I commit sin, God will forgive me if I pray. Amen. I'm telling you, amen, if you willfully sin, there remaineth no more sacrifice for you.
Yes,
amen. And God does not have to hear your voice voice of repentance. Amen. And who can stop the hand of God? Amen. Praise God. He said, if I be for you, who can be against you? But I'm telling you, if God's against you, who can be for you? Amen. Esau cried. Amen. But he decided, I need to sell this out. Amen. For a bowl of beans. That's all it was lentils. Amen. He thought he was starving to death. Amen. Instead of trusting in his God to feed him, he called upon Jacob, his brother. Amen.
Come on, brother. That's true.